children, and this year, 80 confirmed cases in the U.S. We have an expert here in the studios to talk about it. Now, it's very, very rare, Dr. I know, but it's something that people are concerned about because of the symptoms that you can have. Dr. Lee Fireman with MedStar Health is here to talk to us about it. What are some of the signs and symptoms? Because people hear about this AFM and they're terrified.
Absolutely. So it's really important to know that, you know, you want to recognize what the symptoms are. So it's going to be starting with a viral illness, maybe a cold or a cough, and then it can progress after that into weakness of the arm or the leg. And then that's going to cause maybe difficulties with walking or moving. This doesn't happen rapidly to the extent that you're all of a sudden going to have those symptoms. It's going to start with weakness, tingly, and then those would be symptoms that the parents would want to make sure that they talk to their doctor and find out if there's any concerns.
Mm-hmm. Now, I know we've had 80 confirmed cases in the U.S. 6 were being investigated in Maryland, but 1 is actually being concerned. This is something, though, that the CDC is concerned about.
They are. And so the medical community is looking at it and trying to figure out why is this occurring. Mm-hmm. And it's important to identify it from other reasons of both having fever and being sick, which could just be a viral illness, or is there other reasons why there's some weakness? So if there is problems or concerns, you go to your doctor, and then if this is going on where you have true paralysis, then you'd end up at a referral center in one of the hospitals, and they would need to then test and make sure that this is not a treatable cause, mm-hmm. but one of the other reasons that you could find weakness, there's some treatments for. This is not polio.
Okay.
Polio is an infectious disease that is catchy from person to person. This is not contagious between people. So one individual could have it in a family and no one else would have it.
Now, in some cases, it's worse than others, though. Some people recover from it, others don't, right?
Absolutely. So it could just be a mild weakness. Mm-hmm. It could go on to progress not only to not being able to walk, but even going to the breathing muscles. And then that would be something where it's more severe and they'd be hospitalized, but you'd then be in the hospital that they would recover and improve so that hopefully there may only be a remainder of some mild symptoms. There's no treatment for this.
Okay.
This is one of those illnesses that we want to make sure that we're trying to figure out why it's happening, and so then maybe there can be a cause that's identified. There's been question of, is this an infection mm-hmm. that's contagious or caught? But that also hasn't occurred. They've seen that there's patterns of an outbreak, that it's happened in alternate years. It's only really been tracked for about 4 years that we've identified that it's around. And keep in mind that this is rare. We've only seen, as you said, 80 cases
across
the country. Compared that to influenza, where we've already had over 20,000 cases of the flu.
Okay. All right. Something that you need to be on the lookout for. Doctor, thanks so much for coming in.
Thank you for having me.
We're going to have much more information on our website. To read more about acute flaccid myelitis, visit our website at WMER2news.com/